When learning about genetics, you may not ever consider where these concepts originated. You simply try and understand them. However, before we knew the intricate details of the genetic code, some of the predominant mysteries were to do with what a gene even was. Seymour Benzer, a physicist turned biologist, started to decipher this puzzle in 1959 with a paper entitled On the Topology of the Genetic Fine Structure. However, before we can discuss that, let's time travel back to some of the genetic knowledge in 1959. Watson and Crick had discovered the double helix DNA, Stuart Vant had mapped the chromosome, and Muller had theorized that a gene was mutable and heritable. However, it was only just realized that DNA, not proteins, form genes, but the internal structure was still a mystery. Benzer was inspired by the book written by Erwin Schrödinger, who questioned the physical nature of genes. Research Benzer did a few years before the paper in question became pivotal in his later discovery. He was working with the T4 bacteriophage, more specifically its R2 region. When testing its growth on two E. coli strains, B and K, he found that bacteriophages with mutations in the R2 region could not grow on K. Such a clear phenotype allowed him to discern mutants with ease. The T4 bacteriophage was selected not only because of this phenotype, but because large populations were easily obtainable and generation time was fast, so there was a high frequency of mutants to test. Benzer's experiment was based on crossing two mutants to determine whether recombination between them would produce a standard type phage that could multiply on K. If growth on K occurred, the mutants were defective in different places, but if the mutated region was identical, there would be no growth on K. Noting the results from each cross allowed him to answer not how far apart mutations were, but if they touched or not. To illustrate the methods used, let's imagine the R2 region as a netball team, and an incomplete netball team cannot take the court, similarly to how mutated T4 cannot grow on the K strain. Say there is a team who is missing their wing defence, but another team says they can offer one of their players. If that player was not a wing defence, no functional team would be created, similar to mutations in the same spot. However, if the player offered was a wing defence, a full team would be able to take the court, like two different mutations. A key exclusion from the data were leaky mutants. A leaky mutant is one that reverts back to the standard form. For example, the missing netball player just coming late. These were omitted because they multiply on K after reverting, which would have been counted as a recombination and skewed the results. It is important to note that this experiment allowed Benzer to map the gene because the growth on K phenotype was so sensitive that even a single standard type in 1 million mutants would produce growth on K. This is a figure similar to one in the paper, which more clearly shows how this test was used to determine structure. Take mutant 455 and C51. They clearly have no overlap and could recombine, producing a standard type. Benzer also tested whether this phenotype involved multiple parts, where loss of any would mean no growth. A cis-trans test was used where Benzer determined that there were two cistrons, a term he coined. Each mutation fit cleanly into either group A or B, showing that the K phenotype in the R2 region was reliant on two genes or cistrons. These cistrons were precisely linear segments. Both these experiments and discoveries led to Benzer proving that the gene was linear. However, it was not ruled out that more complex structures could exist. The only conclusion he came to in this paper was that the data fit a linear structure, which would be impossible if it was more complexly looped. We now know that he was right in saying the internal structure of a gene is linear. At the time, what is referred to now as classical genetics, which is genetics not based on molecular biology, was dominant. So that meant the current understanding of a gene was that it was just an invisible entity. Benzer showed that this was not true. He showed that a gene can be broken and mutations can be distributed throughout it. This effectively bridged the gap between classical and modern genetics, demonstrating through the experiments explained that not only is a gene not a single point, but multiple parts can mix to fix mutations. Discoveries that came after and were directly influenced by this research were Benzer delving further into the fine structure and eventually determining that mutations could be one nucleotide pair apart, meaning that this was the unit of recombination. This led to the discovery that the ultimate fine structure of a gene was its nucleotide sequence. Crick used the K phenotype of R2 to represent the triplet nature of the genetic code, which was an incredibly influential piece of research for the knowledge of polypeptide chain formation. Overall, Benzer, with the discovery of the internal structure of a gene, contributed to cracking the genetic code and connected basic classical ideas with modern molecular-based genetics.